I want to welcome you here today to this, our Easter Vigil service. We trust that you will join with us as we celebrate the living Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of our dear brothers and sisters, whom you have called out from this world, because they hope and trust in you, command that they be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. And indeed, he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me."
This Easter, we greet you in the name of the living Lord Jesus Christ. Today we rejoice in the fact that our Savior is alive, and that forevermore, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. This should comfort us in all our situations. It should strengthen our faith and sustain us in our trials and succor us in our time of sorrow. The fact that our Savior is alive should encourage us and excite us. This is the message and the theme of our service today, the living Lord Jesus Christ. May he rise up within each of our hearts, and may we give thanks as we celebrate the risen Lord Jesus. Message is an exciting one, not just for the children as they hunt for Easter bunnies or they search for chocolate eggs. It's exciting because it encapsulates everything that we believe as Christians. The Apostle Paul said this, writing to the church at Corinth, "If the Lord Jesus is not risen, then is our faith vain, and we have no hope, and we are of all men most miserable." But if the opposite is true, if the Lord Jesus Christ is risen, then we have hope, not only for today, but for the future that lies ahead of us. Last week, I was watching the news, and I saw something that stirred my heart. It was giving an update on the war in the Ukraine. And in Mariupol, there was a man walking through the streets of destruction and devastation, and he was carrying a self-made cross, an empty cross. And I thought to myself, here was a man who was trying to lift the spirits of his own people, to look beyond their troubles and their trials and their difficulties. You and I need to look beyond our needs today, because the one who is risen, he's alive, he's real, and we need to experience him daily in our hearts and lives. He alone can heal troubled hearts. He alone can solve the problems of nations. He alone can give us peace for today and for the days that lie ahead. When I was in the church, every Easter, I would teach the children a little chorus. Now, I am not a singer, but the words of the little chorus was this. It's what our message is all about today. Jesus is alive today. Jesus is alive today. Jesus is alive, very much alive. Jesus is alive today. That's why the woman that we heard about in the scripture reading, they ran to the tomb, and when they discovered the Lord Jesus, they returned with the greatest message ever told. He is not here. He is risen. That's why Peter and John ran to the tomb. They couldn't believe it. It was too fascinating for them. And yet, they discovered the Lord Jesus Christ. I trust this Easter, in the midst of our circumstances and situations, each one of us will experience the living Lord Jesus Christ. John Newton, the hymn writer who wrote that great hymn, Amazing Grace, also wrote another one, and I conclude with quoting the opening verse. How sweet the name of Jesus sounds in a believer's ear. It soothes our sorrows, heals our wounds, and drives away our fears. I trust this Easter you will experience the presence of the living Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age.
I can face tomorrow, because He lives. All fear is gone, because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives.
It's been a month and a half that our dear Father Vito is gone from us. And we combine the ceremony of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, the living Lord is among us, and we remembering our dear Father Vito. I was privileged last summer up to the season of Advent to go to St. Patrick Church and helped every single Sunday, Father Vito. And I have the opportunity and the privilege to admire his ministry, you know, get to know his personality, and have the joy to be with him on Sunday. And I can sort of explain in one sentence, you know, what I did with him, what I experienced with him. Father Vito was all to everybody. I was amazed to see him while we were waiting to celebrate Mass. I was scared about his flock, about all his faithful. He was phoning, receiving phone call. You know, he made sure that he knew about the health, all his parishioners. So he was really all to all. And sometimes he phoned me and says, Father Peter, just come and help me because I have to go. I have to go to the hospital. I cannot celebrate Mass. So I was there for him. I remember, you know, two things very struck me. It sort of, he felt that maybe his life was coming short. Now, is the season, the beginning of season of Advent. Everybody knows the season of Advent is the beginning of the new liturgical year. So after I celebrate Mass, Father Vito will come for the parish announcements. And he told his parishioner, you know, we are getting to a new year, and next year, which is this year, I'm going to celebrate 40 years that I am priest. And he told his parishioner, do you know what I'm wishing for my 40th anniversary of my ordination? That I will go to Holy Land and celebrate there my ordination. And then it was wonderful. And then when Father Vito came back to the sacristy, I asked him, Father Vito, very good. I like this idea. So I hope all the best for you. And Father Vito, he looked at me and with his eyes, with his smile, like here, hey, Father Peter, I don't know if we'll arrive. I don't know if we'll arrive. And that stick on me. He said, oh, wow, no, he's still young. You know, he got a lot of years in front of him. And now what's happened? That instead to go to Jerusalem and see physically, now he went to the eternal Jerusalem, the celestial Jerusalem, the Jerusalem that in Apocalypse are talking about. We see the new Jerusalem. So Father Vito, he went to his new Jerusalem in heaven. And then one day, you know, few days before he died, I met him at Glendale Funeral Home. We were sharing the ministry here, you know, between the service at the chapel and the blessing of all this wonderful cemetery. And then, you know, he showed to me what is here, what I can see. He showed to me this key. And then, You know, and then the beautiful picture of St. Joseph with baby Jesus Christ. And I said, but Father Vito, usually it's supposed to be St. Peter here having the key. Why you have in mind the key for the ceremony, today's ceremony? And then he told me, you see, Peter, every Sunday the community got together. And every Sunday during the recite of the creed, what we believe? We believe in the communion of saints. So we are in communion with one another here and in heaven. Now, he told me, think about a family. A family, you know, they live in a house, they have a door, and they have the key. To whom? Who has the key of the house? Of course, you know, the parents and some children, or maybe one trusted uncle. The way to enter the communion of the family is enter. So I would like at Easter this year now to give to people that is coming to the funeral home, that's coming to the cemetery, to give them a key, to remember them that through a prayer we are in communion. Sort of the key is open through a prayer, the door of heaven. And opening the door of heaven, we are in communion with all. Here, brothers and sisters, that we are here in this cemetery. So and I was impressed, because usually the key, you can see St. Peter there as the key. They're talking about the key of the kingdom of heaven, the key of forgiven. No, it's the key of communion. We belong to the same family. So Father Vito now is in heaven with the key that now with the key and through our prayer today, together we are in communion with him in heaven. And then I would like to close with an idea, especially, you know, something that struck me when I saw a rose. Now you can see this rose, okay? And the image that I have, I think for me, it make a lot of sense and it touched my heart. You see this rose. Rose can lose its smell. Sometimes, you know, it's withered, there is no smell anymore. The rose could lose the color. Eh? This fine for this color, for instance, is no rose, but why? And then another thing, a rose also can wither the petals. Eh? You take all the petals, you put right here, you hold the petals, and we give to him. So even if he loses all the petals, his name is Rose. He stays a rose. So this is the memory of our dear Father Vito. Even if we don't see his smile like here anymore, even if we don't hear his voice anymore, even if we don't enjoy anymore his counseling, you know, is to take care of us, but in our heart, here in this compound at Glendale, Father Vito stays all the time. Father Vito, his name stays in our mind, is in our heart, and is our prayer. And then I would like in the end to ask Reverend Brian to come, because at his church, Father Vito has a beautiful, beautiful devotion of Our Lady of Knock. And I would like Reverend Brian to explain to you, you know, the devotion.
The Our Lady of Knock, it's a picture, there's a statue in St. Patrick's Church of Our Lady of Knock. It's very interesting. Pope John the 23rd came to County Mayo to Knock Church, and I had the privilege of being there the year after he came. And it symbolizes that there was a vision of the Virgin Mary and angels in that church. And so they did a memorial for Our Lady of Knock.
And now I would like, you know, to say one Hail Mary and ask the Our Lady of Knock to open an arm as a mother and welcome Vito in his new home in heaven. Let's say the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in our death. Amen. And Father Vito wrote a prayer to Our Lady of Knock that says, help me to remember that we are all pilgrims on the road to heaven. And in the end, pray for me now and in hour of our death. Amen.
People of all ages gathered round the gobble wall for an humble man and woman, little children at your call. We are gathered here before you, and our hearts are just the same, filled with joy at such a vision, as we praise your name. Golden Rose, Queen of Ireland, all my cares and troubles see. Among men
In closing, let us say together the prayer that our Lord taught his disciples. Our Father, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship and communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, remain, and abide with each one. Amen. Amen.
My memorial of Father Vito, I show to you this key, very beautiful key with the image of Saint Joseph and the baby Jesus. So Jesus is coming to heaven. Now you wonder, how can we get this key? Keys were blessed by Father Vito 2 weeks before he died. So to have these keys, please get on the Glendale website, and they will be distributed the 10th of April, which is the Palm Sunday. So the hours will be posted on the Glendale website. Thank you very much. I hope to see you a lot. Please take the key and treasure, because this is very important and a good memento of Father Vito. Thank you very much.